Welcome to the session on 8086 system bus architecture minimum mode. At the end of this session, students will be able to describe the minimum mode operation of an 8086 based system. Let us see minimum mode 8086 system. So if you are observing 8086 microprocessor, the 8086 is configured in minimum mode when its MN/MX pin is connected to logic 1, and in this mode all the control signals are given out by the microprocessor chip itself. There is a single microprocessor in the minimum mode system. To adapt to different situations, the 8086 processor can be operated either in the minimum or the maximum mode. And the minimum mode is used for small system with single processor and in any system. Okay. So here the block diagram consisting components in the system are latches, transceivers, clock generator, memory and I/O devices. Clock is provided by the 8284 clock generator. It provides clock reset ready input to the 8086. Latches are generally buffered output D type flip-flops like 8282, and they are used for separating the valid addresses from the multiplexed address and data signals, and are controlled by the ALE signals generated by 8086, and the data bus is driven through 8286 8-bit transceivers, and two such transceivers are needed as the data bus is 16-bit. The transceivers are enabled through the DEN signal while the direction of data is controlled by the DT/R signal, M/IO, RD and WR are decoded by 3 as 8 decoder like 74138. Bus request is done using the hold and HLDA signal. Now here the microprocessor 8086 pin diagram is available, and here if you are observing, 8086 is operated in mini mode by strapping its MN/MX pin to +5V or logic 1. Okay. Now also one more very important thing is pin configuration, that is pin definitions from 24 to 31 are different for minimum mode, and by using these pins the 8086 itself generates all bus control signals in the system bus configurations of 8086. So now Intel 8086 pin details regarding minimum mode operations. That is how and what are the number of pins are available in for controlling the minimum mode configuration. So 8086 generates all bus control signals in the minimum mode configuration, and these signals are first INTA, that is interrupt acknowledge, its output signal. This indicates recognition of an interrupt request. Second, ALE, address latch enable output. Again, it's an output signal. This signal is provided by 8086 to demultiplex the AD0, AD15 into A0 to A15 and D0 to D15 using external latches. And the third one, DN, that is data enable output. This signal informs the transceivers that the CPU is ready to send or receive data. Next, DT oblique R, that is data transmit and receive output. That again it's output signal. This signal is used to control data flow direction. High on this pin indicates that the 8086 is transmitting the data, and low indicates that 8086 is receiving the data. And the next pin, M/IO, it's the output signal. It is used to distinguish memory data transfer and IO data transfer. When M/IO is high, there is memory data transfer, and if M/IO is low, then it is a IO data transfer. And the sixth one, WR, it's a write output, and WR is low whenever the 8086 is writing data into memory or an IO device. 7, hold, it is a input signal. HLDA, it's a output signal. A high on hold pin indicates that another master is requesting to take over the system bus. On receiving hold signal processor output, that is HLDA signal, high as an acknowledgement. So here you have a question. If MN/MX is high, the 8086 operates in dot dot mode. So you have four options. Please think on this question and try to write your answer. Your answer is B. If MN/MX is tied to ground, 8086 operates in maximum mode. And MN/MX is tied to VCC, the processor 8086 operates in minimum mode. Now, the 8086 bus cycle are depicted with their T states in the figure, and the length of bus cycle in the 8086 system is 4 clock cycles denoted by T1 to T4 plus any number of wait states clock cycles denoted by TW. If the bus is to be inactive or idle after the completion of bus cycle, the gap between successive bus cycle is filled with ideal state. And the simplified timing diagram for the memory or IO read cycle, which requires one wait state in the minimum mode, is shown here in this figure. If an input operation, that is read operation, is to be performed, RD is active low during T2, and the AD0 pin should enter a high impedance state in preparation for receiving the input data, and the memory or IO interface is ready to transfer data immediately, there are no wait states and the data is put on the bus during T3. After the input data is accepted by the 8086, RD is raised to 1 at the beginning of the T4, and memory or IO interface removes its data upon detecting this transition. Okay, now we are coming to the part of write cycle timing diagram in the minimum mode. The simplified timing diagram for the memory or IO write cycle, which requires one wait state in the minimum mode, is shown here in this figure. For an output operation, that is write operation, the 8086 makes the signal WR equals to 0 and place the output data in the pins AD15, AD0 during T2. During T4, WR is made logic 1 and the data is removed. For both input and output operation, DN is made logic 1 during T4 to disable the transceiver. and the M/IO signal is set to according to the next data transfer at this time. Now we are coming to the summary part. 8086 works in minimum mode when MN/MX equals to 1. Minimum mode, 8086 is the only processor in this system. Clock is provided by the 8284 clock generator. It provides clock reset and ready input to 8086. These are my references. Thank you.